So, hey everybody, welcome to another episode, which I have decided to actually change the title. You see, normally this would be group therapy, because I have a guest with me today.
Hi, I'm Where IsNovember.
And, you know, she's lovely, isn't she? She's been helping me out.
Aw, you're so
sweet. Well, you've been helping me out with, like, Silent Hill 2, which, you know, probably not on the channel yet, but, you know, it's coming. I figure it's going to be after Mega Man 4, but that's besides the point. I decided to change the title. You see, I called it group therapy, but then I thought about it and it's like, that's a stupid title. Not because, like, it's not iconic of this thing. It's just, I felt like it's also kind of misleading. Because really, it's more like you're just chilling with me, just hanging out. So I decided I'm going to call it Hangin' with Gildem. So every group therapy out now, it's just like, it's going to be changed to Hangin' with Gildem. And you're hanging with Gildem, so it's very iconic of what it is. I think it's a lot more fitting as a title. That's what I'm trying to get at.
Sounds good.
Yeah. Anyways, so this is just, you know, you, me, talking about this, that, whatever.
And this volume needs to go down because it's distracting.
I was thinking about that, but you know what? You did it. You read my vibe, so it's like, it's all good. Dude, we're totally in sync today. It's fantastic. Anyways, so, yeah, this is kind of weird because usually I have something on my mind whenever I go into these things. I don't. And also, these things are completely unscripted, so sorry if it seems a little bit slow at the start. You just never know where it's gonna go, and so actually, this game, very fitting in that sense.
And to a certain extent, it's been years since I've played this. I'm the one that's playing this right now. I'm gonna hand this off to Gildem at some point.
Nah, man, it's all good. I mean, like I said, we've been doing the Silent Hill 2. I've been playing. I mean, it's good to actually have a mix up because usually I'm the one doing these things. It's nice to actually have someone else take the reins.
Yeah, just so you know, I'm not very good at multitasking, though. So
don't worry about it.
I'm not very good at this game while you guys are watching it.
Yeah, don't worry about it.
But
see,
it's
like
nice
I said,
eye candy, right?
Yeah, it's eye candy. It's not really meant to be the focus of it. It's just, it's like a counseling session, which I don't know if you've ever done, but let me tell you something. You just kind of go in, talk about whatever you want, and then by the end of it, you don't even know if it helped. But, you know, you at least you felt like you were social.
True.
Yeah, and let me tell you something. I went to counseling. It's stupid. Sometimes. Because, I don't know, it was probably because I didn't have a good counselor.
To be honest, I've noticed that counselors aren't nearly as good as, like, psychologists.
Yeah, I mean, that's also probably one of the things. Also, don't psychologists usually tend to prescribe medication while counselors
are
more
psychiatrists.
See, I'm getting them all mixed up.
Psychologists have to have some biology training, although not medical.
Mm-hmm.
Psychiatrists have to have medical training. They have to have a doctorate in both psychology and a medical degree.
Gotcha.
And counselors only need a master's degree.
Okay, well,
master's certificate.
Well, all I'm saying is, like, I had a counselor, you know, it was pretty cool. Like, I don't want to insult the guy and say that he was total garbage, because he wasn't. It was just one of those things where, basically, all I would do, whatever's going on, and it wasn't always like I had an issue. It was more like, I would talk about, like, this, that. Some weeks were really slow, so it's like I just go in, talk about whatever, and then all of a sudden it's like, man, I didn't really leave with anything.
Yeah, and as psychologists and psychiatrists would probably be more apt to ask you to revisit some things that you were struggling with earlier.
Oh, they do. And, you know, that's the problem. Like, I tend to move from issues that I have in the past. So, it's not like when they get brought up, it's like super detrimental where it's like, oh, you're revisiting topics I don't want to talk about. I'm totally acting like James and being disconnected at this point. James from
Silent Hill
2.
Yeah.
Yeah. Where it's like, you know, he has outbursts when he remembers things that he doesn't want to.
Yeah, that is a pretty classic example of someone who is emotionally deregulated.
Yeah. My point, I'm just saying, like, there are times where I have things that are really just slow, and I mean, granted, this segment, it's not really meant to talk about your week. You can get as heavy as you want. I don't really give a shit. I'm serious. Like, you can be as real as you want to be, and that's what I like about this. But really, it's just kind of a segment where you can just kind of talk about whatever. So, in a sense, it really is like a counseling session. I'm just not qualified to do that shit.
Well, there are group therapy places that do not actually have anyone with a degree on staff, it's just people listening to other people.
Yeah, well, I mean, that's why, I think that's why intentionally I was calling it group therapy, because, you know, it kind of really is that, except I guess it's more like just two people, because, you know, it's me, you, we're here. And I do this with other people. It's just, I don't know, it's just, I think it's a little misleading, because sometimes it's not like we really have any topics or anything super critical we have to address. It's just kind of chilling, hanging out.
Yeah.
I like that. I like hanging out with you.
Yeah, I like hanging out with you too.
Yes! I have a friend. Actually, we are best friends. Despite what anyone says, we're told besties.
Definitely.
You give me cookies. How can I not be your best friend?
Cookies are awesome.
Dude, cookies are amazing. I think the only thing better is ice cream, but I mean, it's a real close competition there. Like, the line is just paper thin. And I mean, like, you combine ice cream and cookies? Oh. I have no words. I'm speechless. That's how good it is. It's like just the holiest of desserts, in my opinion. Nothing compares.
What about ice cream cake?
Well, it's not like cookies, though. Unless you put the cookies with the ice cream and put that in a cake, then it's like, oh.
What about slutty brownies?
I don't think I've ever had those.
The slutty brownies.
No, wait, I think you, either, like, you gave me one or, like,
I have not made them.
Okay, I don't know. I feel, this is a term I've heard.
So it is, it's chocolate chip cookie wheat.
Yeah.
So, set on the bottom, and then you put Oreos.
Okay.
Around, and then you drench that in brownie batter, and you bake it.
Oh man, that sounds good.
Doesn't it?
I mean, like, to be honest, I'm huge on sweets, so it doesn't take me much to get invested.
Yeah, just so you know, though, sugar can have the same effect on your liver as alcohol.
I believe it. Hell, when I have, like, too much sugar, I get sick.
Yeah, same here.
Yeah. And don't get me wrong, like, I like sugar. I'm addicted to sugar. Yeah. Sugar is a very addictive substance.
Yeah,
can we just get that out of the way?
Yeah, sugar isn't good for you either.
Yeah. But at the same time, let me tell you something.
I've been eating cookies all day.
Yeah. I'm just saying, like...
We're all addicted, and it's in everything.
Oh, my God. But it's so good.
No,
but, I mean, a little bit's fine every now and then. I mean, really, when you get down to
nutrition. It's in everything. That's the issue, is that it is in everything. It is in condiments. It is in bread. It is in sauces.
Yep.
It is in... What else is there that you wouldn't normally think?
I'm not... All right. Is it in the water?
In some waters.
Oh, my God. It's in everything. But listen, I drink from taps, so I don't really know what that's saying. Some people don't like fluoride in tap water, but I say whatever. I'm fine with fluoride in the tap.
I don't like the taste of tap water.
Oh, okay. That's fine.
So I drink distilled.
Hey, that's like the cleanest, yes. As far as I know. Like, distilled water is like the cleanest you can get water.
It is delicious. It has no flavor, but it's delicious.
Well, I mean, I always said water doesn't really have much of a flavor to begin with. And I think as a kid, this is why it took me forever to actually... like, start drinking it. Like, seriously, you could not get me to drink water as a kid, but, like, once I started working at my job, I started drinking that shit all the time.
That's good, though. That's good that you're drinking more water.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I think working at where I have, I've drinking, like, more water in my life than even imaginable. And it's like, if you actually compare it to, like, when I was a kid, it's such a shocking value, just, like, how radical that shit was. But at the same time, I mean, like, I guess it's irrelevant. Man, this is a really chill game.
Isn't it? It's really just...
I mean,
there's nothing really to it.
Yeah, I mean, like, I know, like, the segment isn't really to focus on the game, but
It's a pretty game.
Yeah, I just haven't seen anything like this, and this is, like, the chillest thing I've ever really experienced.
This is therapy in a game.
It is, and I like growing stuff. I don't know if I've talked about this. I'm not saying I have a green thumb. I just think there's, like, something rewarding from, like, growing something from a seed.
Absolutely.
Because I had a tomato plant once. It's a sad story towards the end, so I won't bring that part up, because it's like, Gildem, how could you be so cruel? But I just wanted to say...
Did you kill it?
Accidentally.
Well, that happens.
But it was very successful before it died. let me put it this way. It grew pretty high. It got at least, like, I want to say 1.5 feet, and it started producing fruit, and it was like, oh man, this is amazing. I don't even like tomatoes, and, like, already I love this plant.
That's good.
It's like this ironic situation, because, I don't know, it's like, I hate tomatoes, well, sort of, now I tolerate them, but at the same time, it's like, I love this plant, this is something I grew from a seed, and now it's like, it's thriving, and it was amazing.
I have never been that lucky with plants, except for this aloe vera plant that I had.
Well, hey, aloe vera.
Those things, though, are very hard to kill. I still managed to kill it. But they're very hard to kill.
Well, see, with my plant, okay, I guess I'll bring it up because I might as well. Like I said, you can get as real as you want with this. What happened was I brought it outside too early when it was still winter.
Yeah.
And those things are very sensitive to cold.
Yeah. It's very easy to kill plants. It just is.
And, you know, we live in the Northwest, so it's like, hey, it gets cold here.
Yep.
Not snow cold, but, like, cold enough where...
No, snow cold. We've had snow several times.
Yeah, which is odd, because it... For the past couple of years, it hasn't really gotten, like, that crazy.
No. What's been really suck, though, is that at the beginning of February, we had, all of a sudden, we had a ton of snow, and, like, most of my coworkers didn't show up.
I remember, like, during that week, I didn't show up on the Monday because there was a lot of black ice, and I work at nights, so you can only imagine that situation would have been super critical. And apparently, I wasn't, like, the only one. Like, half of the entire populace of the coworkers where I work, mind you, it's a warehouse, so there's quite a few people. They didn't show up. They were severely understaffed, but then again, like, the volume process rate was, like, cut in half, so.
Yeah, that's basically what happened at my work, is that we didn't have enough staff to run the basic function, so I was doing, like, double duty on everything.
Yeah. But at the same time, we didn't have to, like, you couldn't process as much volume, because, like, certain things couldn't get there, so
yeah.
Basically, it was like, it kind of evened out. But
my work was pretty dead, too.
Yeah.
I don't know if I really want to say where I work.
I wouldn't. I mean, like, I don't know if it matters, but for legal reasons, I do not talk about, I don't mention where I work. Just because I feel like I can get in trouble, and I don't want to get in trouble.
Yeah, same.
So it's like...
We're just going to keep quiet about that.
Yeah. We'll move on to a different topic. I just wanted to bring up the fact that, you know, it snowed. Shit be crazy. I don't know if I should really try to portray, like, this sort of Ebonics-type language, but I'm doing it anyways because, you know, it's my segment. I can do whatever I want. You guys have to deal with it. Although, you know, you guys are wonderful. You know, you're here listening to two people just ramble on about stuff, and that's fine, because that's what this is all about.
Where the fuck am I supposed to go?
I don't even know.
I don't either.
Anyways, so going on from, like, snow and plants and everything, let me tell you something. I like broccoli.
Broccoli's good.
Yeah. And I don't get why everyone's like, broccoli is terrible. It's good.
It is good.
It's good. You gotta cook it, right? And I like cooking. I don't do it nearly as much as I wish I did, but I like cooking every now and then.
I like cooking, but the amount of time it takes is what...
Yeah. But I mean, like, that's half the enjoyment from it, you know? Like you're making, like, this big, amazing meal that people are just like, what, you can cook? Actually, I shock people by the fact that, like, I tell them I can cook, and they're like, wait, you can cook?
I don't really understand why people are so surprised when someone can cook, though.
Yeah.
You have to,
it's really easy.
If you can read, you can cook. It's called a recipe.
Yeah. Well, I guess half of it is, like, being able to follow the directions. I feel like...
But that shouldn't be hard.
It shouldn't, but I feel like some people just, they can't follow directions well enough to, like, have it turn out half decent.
I still don't understand that. Perhaps I'm just intolerant, but I don't really understand.
Perhaps I don't get, like, the other half of the argument, you know what I mean? Like, it's like, you figure, like, you can read, you can follow directions, it should relatively turn out half decent, at least. It should be edible on a satisfactory level.
Yeah.
You know, I agree with you.
How much are you changing this shit that you are fucking up the recipe?
Okay, I do have one confession. I was cooking with a friend one time, and we misread tablespoons and teaspoons.
That is one thing. That is a learning experience.
For salt?
Yeah. So and cookies? That's one thing. That's not the same thing as...
Or was it cake? Maybe it was brownies. I don't even remember. It was some sort of baked good.
Okay, so you did kind of ruin it then.
Yeah.
that did happen. That's like a one-time mistake, though. That's not quite the same thing as fucking up every recipe that you try.
And you figure, like, I think I can understand, like, mistakes like that, just because some things you have to be super, attentive to the details.
Yeah.
But, I mean, it's also a learning mistake. Like, you know, that's how you get better at cooking.
Then there are people that will, like, are like, oh, I don't have that, so I'll substitute it, so I'll substitute this. And they do that with, like, every ingredient.
Well, let me put it this way. Baking soda and baking powder are not the same.
No, they're not. They're not even close. Don't.
And some people think they are because they have baking in the middle of, or, like, in the name.
No, they're completely different.
At the beginning.
Again, that's a mistake, though. I can understand a beginner's mistake like that.
Yeah.
Well, but again, that's a one-time mistake that you can learn from.
Yeah. I mean, like, I think I just made this realization, and it's like, I think half the reason why you might get thrown off from cooking is, like, from, like, the beginner's mistakes. If you're one of those people that gets really upset, like, the first time you try something,
and you have... Oh, yeah, you don't get it perfect or something.
Or you don't have the will to try again and try to make it better.
See, here's the thing. If you have a friend, there's a ton of cooking stuff on YouTube. There's a ton of websites
that will
go through. You can avoid making mistakes.
Like ever since
you do a little bit of research.
Yeah, I was just gonna say ever since the internet became such a wide topic and pretty much like a forum when you get down to share ideas and thoughts and recipes. For instance.
Yeah.
I mean, you can pretty much just, like, take ideas and just improve upon them or, like, even try them out for yourself.
Can I promote my website on this thing?
I mean, go for it.
You don't mind?
No.
Okay, so I have a website called thatonelibrary.weebly.com, and if you go on there and you click Life Resources, I have a ton of cooking websites that you can check out.
Yeah, there you go. I'll put a link in the description.
Oh, you're so sweet.
Yeah. Also, since we're plugging things, I might as well plug in my Twitter.
Yes,
I don't really,
Twitter.
I don't really talk about it a whole lot, because, you know, I'm not, like, some big shot, you know, but at the same time, I do have a Twitter. Been using it a little bit more lately, but at the same time, it's, you know, like, I usually put it in the description if anyone wants to follow me, you feel free to, but at the same time, it's, you don't have to. I wouldn't enforce that, you know, just like how I don't enforce subscribing or, you know, commenting, liking, whatever, all that good stuff that all the popular channels usually do.
Do you know why they do that, though?
Well, because, you know, views equals money. That AdSense revenue.
It's not only that, but the more audience engagement stuff that you have, the more likely you are to be featured.
I guess.
It's the way the YouTube algorithm works.
Man, let me put it this way. Gildem ain't ever going to get featured, because the day Gildem gets featured, I think the internet would break and hell would freeze over. A lot of people say, dude, man, you shouldn't think like that, but it's just like, come on, man.
Self-deprecation is one of the five food groups.
I mean, yeah, you know, and it's like, I feed on that stuff. But the real thing is, I like making people laugh, and on the offhand chance someone comes by and, you know, I actually do something silly and they get a chuckle at it, I feed on that shit. It's delicious. Oh, it's so, yes, it's like, let me feed! I don't know, does that make me some sort of weird, like, incubus?
Well,
I mean, not in the sexual term, but, like, in the, like, absorbing, like, the humor from, like, people's laughter.
I mean, that's...
It has kind of the same vibe, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. I'm not trying to make this awkward. I'm just trying to make this weird association.
No, the only reason why it's weird for me is because I was just playing Seduce Me Ultimate.
What? Oh. Is that one of those dating simulator games?
Yes.
Oh, okay. All right. Sorry.
Yeah, the focus that all of the love interests were incubi.
What? The only reason I know incubus is because I play Shin Megami Tensei, and they have a lot of weird Christianity and, like...
Speaking of Shin Megami Tensei, Are you familiar at all with Persona? Have you played Persona?
Dude, I beat Persona 3. It was like one of the most...
Wasn't that awesome?
Oh, it was just one of the most...
Oh, I'm so glad that someone else
special moments in my gaming
Persona
history
5
life.
Is coming out. In
oh, dude. So, I think I brought it up with someone. You cannot go in with... let me try to rephrase this so I don't fuck it up. You cannot go into Persona 4 with the same mindset you have for Persona
Agreed.
3.
I made that mistake when because I bought Persona 4 when it first came out because I love Persona 3 yeah. so much. And I went into it expecting another Persona 3. It is not anywhere near the same. The tone is completely different. I was so pissed off by it that I kind of ruined the game for myself.
And, I mean, like, you're not the only one. Everyone who I've ever talked about Persona 3 and 4, like, they say the same thing. You cannot go in... with the same mindset you have for Persona 3, because Persona 3 has a very serious tone to it, especially
yeah.
towards the end. I mean, it's also really beautiful in the way that they, like, tell this story, and,
it
you know,
is.
I love it.
Yeah.
But the problem is, like, going into Persona 4, I think one of my coworkers said it best. He said, you have to go in like you're gonna watch an episode of Scooby-Doo.
Yeah, it's like a 90-hour episode of Scooby-Doo. That's
yeah.
what it is.
And so, basically, you have to go in with, like, this fun mystery, like, mindset. And so, it sounds really odd just, like, from that kind of context, just hearing that. Because it's like, I like Persona 3. I thought it was fantastic. The boss fight was balls. I'm not gonna lie, it's like this 13-stage boss fight.
Yeah, I love that, though. That was awesome.
The first 12 are easy.
The first 12 are pretty easy.
Yeah, you'll just fly through them, but then you get to that last one, and you're just like, what just happened? Because the tone radically shifts.
Not only that, but the way I did it was, I went into it with that, I don't remember the spell name, but the one that blocks all physical attacks, and then there's one that blocks
yeah.
all magical attacks.
Yeah.
I just spam that constantly, so I was able to get through to that.
I know what you're talking about, but I don't know what
I want to say it's Makarakarn and Tetrakarn.
That, I believe it. It's been a while. Persona has, like, all these weird, like, spell names.
They do.
Yeah.
But the 13th stage uses magic that is immune to... to any of that spell, so
yeah.
you end up getting spam full force with it.
Yeah, I believe it. I remember I got really lucky. Like, when I say the boss fight was balls, I literally got into a last character alive situation where basically it was completely just, like, my other party member's dead. I was the only one that was alive, and the only way I could survive was constantly keep healing myself after every attack.
Yeah.
I got lucky, and the boss broke... like, the pattern and missed. And
oh,
so I was
man.
Able to slowly just revive my party up to snuff. And so I got myself out of this this unwinnable loop and actually was able to win. I did a 180 in the whole entire situation. And that was one of the moments where it was just like... like, you feel this sense of pride and accomplishment as a gamer, you know? Like,
yeah.
you did a good job. You got out of, like, an unwinnable situation and actually... got on top, and it, you know, the Shin Megami Tensei series, not just Persona, like, the whole series, those games will beat you down.
Yeah.
Like, no tomorrow. Like, they're balls hard.
Yeah. I actually found recently, when I went to sell some of my games, I found, Digital Devil Saga.
Oh, I have both of those. I have not played them. I don't know why.
I haven't played them either, but it's on my two playlists.
Yeah. Oh, I played a little bit of the first one, because it's like a two-game saga, as
yeah.
far as I know. I have both of them. I really want to play the second one, or I want to play the first one so I can move on to the second one. But at the same time, I hear that it's so weird, because essentially you don't get a lot of the same tropes that you do where you have, like, a monster recruit system. Instead, you are the monster, but you level up accordingly.
Oh, that's interesting.
I think it's a lot more traditional. I think that's really what I'm getting at.
Oh, it should still be interesting to play.
Oh, yeah. Oh, it's beautiful.
I have Persona 1 and 2 for the original PlayStation 2. Not PlayStation 2, for the original
yeah,
PlayStation.
Yeah,
well.
I still need Persona 2. I have Persona for the PSP.
I was able to get Persona 2 at... one of the used game stores.
Oh my god. If it's what I think it is, you took it from the case.
Yes.
Because I remember there. Okay, so there's a used game store around here, and I went to it one time with one of my ex-buddies. I'm not really going to get into it because, you know, it's a little too real for the tone that we're portraying right now. But long story short, I went in there. They had Persona 2 in the display case at the front counter.
Yeah, they did.
And I was like, oh, man, I want to get that, but it was like $100-something.
No.
Or it was a lot. I remember that
much. It was a lot, but that wasn't how much.
Okay, well, see, you probably remember. I remember in the triple digits, but maybe it was just in the high doubles. You know,
it was in the very low triple digits.
Okay.
But yeah.
Well, I mean that's what I'm saying. It was like 100-something. Anyways, not the point. The point is you got it.
Yep, I got it.
Yep. Okay. So that's I figured out what happened to that game. Someone bought it, and it was my best friend.
I still need the PSP versions of those two games.
I need the PSP version of, like, the second game.
I need the PSP version of both 1 and 2, because I would like to actually play the Ice Queen side quest thing.
Huh.
Because there's a way to actually bypass the entire actual storyline and go on this big side thing.
Really?
That will actually end the game once you finish it.
Huh.
It's like there's two games in one game.
That's kind of bizarre.
Yeah.
I mean, that's like pushing the envelope on like the capabilities. But then again, I mean, I wouldn't expect anything less of Atlas, because they're pretty unconventional when it comes to a lot of games.
Atlas and Axies.
Axies.
Axis, Axies. I'm not okay. Totally sure.
Yeah, it's fine. My point is, the Ice Queen, is it related to Jack Frost?
No. Okay. It is something that takes place in the school. Like, you end up not leaving the school at all.
I gotcha. Kind of reminds me of Corpse Party from the sound alone.
I don't think it's quite like
school. No. But I'm just saying, like, from the fact that you can't leave the school. I mean, that for some reason, I associate that with, like, a Corpse Party vibe. Because, I mean, that's the whole thing about Corpse Party. You get trapped in this spiritual dimension world where, you know, like, spooky stuff is happening, and you want to leave, but you can't, because they're like, no, you're trapped here for life.
I have to say, the one thing I don't really care for as much about Persona 1 and 2 is that they don't have the social system.
No. Oh, yeah, I remember, because, like, it's more of a,
more of a standard RPG.
Yeah, well, I was going to say, it's more, it was, like, before that, you know, it was before they really had the capabilities, or it was just before they really
invested in dating sims.
Yeah.
Storylines, yeah.
And, I mean, like, as far as I know, Final Fantasy VII was kind of like, I want to say it wasn't the first. It was kind of like a beta game concept where they put that in. No one really thinks about that, or at least I don't, because, like, you overlook it.
Yeah.
And most of the time, you just kind of default to Aerith, because, you know, she's the white mage. She's going to be able to heal your party, and so it's like, oh, well, pretty much by default, you're going to have Aerith on your date.
Yeah.
But you can have, like, a multitude of people, including Barret. Believe it or not, that's actually a possibility.
Really?
Yep. You can go on that one Gold Saucer dating, like, side thing with Barret.
That's interesting.
Yeah. I don't really associate with that too much, because, I mean, that's something that happens, but it's like, you don't really think about that, or at least I never do it. You have to intentionally go in, like, trying to do that. I think that's one of the harder things to do. Like, you intentionally have to aim for that, and you have to, like, avoid Aerith like the plague. Or is it Aerith?
Gotcha.
Yeah.
It depends on how it was translated.
Yeah, well, I mean, like,
Aerith is technically more correct.
I think Aerith is, like, how it's now, but, like, back in the day, it was, like, Aerith.
It was Aerith.
Yeah, because it was, like, yeah, it was, like, the S, and then it went TH, or it's that, or it's the other way around, but I think it's...
No, Aerith is current.
Yeah.
And then Aerith was old school.
And so it's like, I kind of switch between the two, because it's like, I grew up with the old school. Let me tell you something. I don't know how I feel about the remake. I'm really torn. Because on one hand, Final Fantasy VII, yo. On the other hand, it's like, they changed so much of it already from what I hear.
Really?
It's not the game I want. First off, when they mentioned it was episodic, I already just kind of started shaking my head.
Oh, I didn't hear that it was episodic.
Oh, that was a long time ago, but now...
I haven't been keeping up.
No, that's fine. I mean, really, like, only a set select amount of stuff has been revealed. The current thing I heard recently, and this might upset you, so, you know, feel free to give your live reaction. Apparently, a lot of the things, like Crisis Core, I think Dirge of Cerberus, like, a lot of that stuff, has been debunked.
Good. I hated those games.
Even Crisis Core?
I actually never played Crisis Core.
Okay. I hear Crisis Core is, like, really, really good.
but hated Dirge of Cerberus.
I was not a fan. I really wasn't. So it's like, no complaints here. I have a couple people that really liked it, though. And it's like, man, have you tried beating it? I have a lot of issues with Dirge of Cerberus. You know what? Screw it. I'm extending it just so I can rant about Dirge of Cerberus. Everyone fine with this?
Yep, I'm good.
Okay. So, you want to know my biggest complaint with Dirge of Cerberus?
What?
It's the fact that you have this underground secret laboratory on top of the secret laboratory.
I actually...
You have, like, what is it? It's like, I don't know, it's like Root Ambu Black Ops for, like, Naruto, where it's like, yeah, you have the secretive, like, Ambu Black Ops, but then apparently there's Ambu Black Ops Root. But my point is, because I'm getting off topic, so, in order to fill in the bullshit with, like, this new Shinra whatever, because you have, like, these secret operatives with fun names like Foxhound, you have, like, what is it? It's like Rosaro the Crimson, Azul the Cerulean, I forget, like, the rest of them. I think there's one called Nero, but I forget what he is. My point is, like, basically, they're like, these secret agent operatives, much like Vincent is. And they have, like, these transformations that they can do much like Vincent can.
Okay.
And so, like, supposedly, oh, yeah, it's all a secret program by Shinra, which was made to, like, do a thing. And it turns out, like, apparently Vincent is, like, this chosen one, some sort of bullshit Neo whatever. And so you go through it, and you're like, why the fuck did they have a secret lab? What was the purpose? They were already doing illegal research. And really, like, to me, it just rubbed me the wrong way, because it's like they're trying to cover their ass so they can create mindless bullshit. You know what would have made more sense to me?
What?
If they had an offset lab that wasn't in Midgar. It was, like, on some offset site. Like, I don't know, put it on the island where Wutai is, or, like, somewhere else. You have reactors. Why does Midgar have to be the only one producing all these things? In fact, you go to Nibelheim, you have this illegal research where they're trying to produce soldiers that are connected to Genova, and it mutates them in this weird thing, but you see a picture of that, so it's like, I don't really need to describe it. My point is, they had options. Why try to create the secret lab that's underground from Midgar?
Because reasons.
Bullshit.
Money.
Bullshit.
Money.
I mean, like, that's not my counter argument. I mean, that's just my basis for all of it. It's like, listen, I get it. We all want to go back to Midgar and see all the visuals, but we don't need... Listen, Midgar, I don't know, make it like the travel hub or something. Like, make it in Vincent's downtime, he, like, goes to this hub and he visits things, much like Travis Town in Kingdom Hearts.
Oh, yeah.
You don't need the secret lab that's underground from the giant lab that is basically the Shinra Corporation Tower. It's bullshit. They didn't need to add it. They added it. There's like, yeah, look at all this. We got stuff. And then Hojo was still alive, which I gotta be honest. I'm fine with Hojo because, I don't know, that motherfucker was smart. He was a scientist. I figure he'd find some bullshit reason for surviving, much like Dr. Gero in Dragon Ball Z. Or any other mad scientist that finds some way to extend their life, even though physically they're dead.
Yeah.
My point is, Hojo found a way, and he was probably the best part of it, and I think I heard somewhere that basically the voice actor for Vexen, at least in the Japanese version, is the same guy who voiced Hojo in Dirge of Cerberus. Yeah, and so it's like, you got that, and he's got the creepy laugh, and it's all that, and it's like, when I get down to it, I think I can see Vexen from Kingdom Hearts. Organization 13. I can see him being the Hojo character because he's a creepy motherfucker.
Yeah.
Who's a scientist.
Alright, so we are reaching the end of this stage. Do you want to stop your recording or do you
want to continue? I mean, like, I really have nothing to say. 3-minute rant on, like, bullshit I hate of Dirge of Cerberus, so I don't know. That's the only plot I really had to complain about. I guess that's the timer for it to say it's over, so I'm ending the part. Thank you for listening. It's been wonderful. This is Hanging Out with Gildem, and Where's November? She joined us.
Yes,
I'm gonna give you I'm gonna give you the parting words.
Thank you for watching, and see us next Sunday. You next Sunday.
Yeah.
Something like that. I don't know. Next Sunday.
I'll have a new guest.
Yes.
Or it'll be another rambling video. It'll be solo, or someone's joining me. I don't know.
Who knows?
Yeah. All right.
Bye.